Hey guys, what's up? It's Brian Max here with another No BS car review. And if you're here because you're asking yourself, should I buy an Alfa Romeo Stelvio TI Sport? Well, I've got the answer to that question. Seriously, if you are here and you're asking yourself that question, well, the good news is I've put a ton of miles on the Stelvio and have plenty to talk to you about today. However, what you do need to know is that, you know, there's not a lot that's mediocre with the Stelvio. That doesn't mean everything's awesome, because there's plenty of stuff that's awesome about the Stelvio, but there are also some things that are not so awesome, and, you know, we'll get into those in a minute. Straight off the top though, this Stelvio is one of the most interesting and desirable and stylish SUVs. It is very, very unique and a much better choice than just about everything else in the segment. In case you're wondering, it's still winter here. This poor Stelvio is filthy, filthy on the outside because it's winter. And it's also the very drab, very boring gray color on the outside. And that's just not gonna be very pretty. So we're not gonna use that footage. We're just gonna use what our friends at FCA have provided while I babble on to you about the Stelvio. But there are a lot of considerations, and I love so much of the Stelvio. So one thing I gotta say is that the Stelvio definitely puts sport in sport utility. It handles fantastically, and you've got a lot of confidence behind the wheel to hustle this thing. And part of that is because it retains the very quick steering that the Giulia has, and that is so unique. You'd think though that it would make the car a little more nervous on the freeway, but it actually doesn't. It's very, very stable and not nervous at all, despite the very quick steering. And you know, that is that's something you don't see on too many modern cars. Most modern cars and crossovers and SUVs have a very slow steering rack, and this is not one of them. It's very quick and makes it much more enjoyable. And speaking of which, seats are fantastic, despite the fact they're limited in terms of their number of adjustments, but they're very supportive and very, very comfortable. And, you know, I've gone on a couple of longer road trips in this, and I'm not fatigued or sore or worn out at all. It's a very, very comfortable SUV. So, about those ways in which the Stelvio is not awesome, well, here's one. Just like the Giulia, the infotainment unit doesn't come from other FCA divisions where they could have liberated the excellent Uconnect that you find in humble Dodges and Jeeps. Instead, they did their own thing, and it's only okay. It's not great. The interface is simple enough, but it's generally slow to operate and respond to your commands. You'd think with something all new from Alfa Romeo, it would be flawed in some fundamental ways, and it's actually not. There's plenty of storage in here, and you know, under the hatch there's lots of space. There's no problem. I've thrown bicycles back there, a couple of them, and without disassembling them, of course, and that was fantastic. Very easy to use, very easy to live with. There's a remote start, which you don't see on many SUVs and crossovers from outside of North America, so it's a nice thing to have, clearly designed for us North Americans, and that's great. The other real consideration is that it's a head turner. Even in this boring gray color, it really does turn heads. And it's because nobody's seen an SUV from Alfa Romeo before. Plus, it's a very attractive SUV as well. So that helps. I mean, not only is it special, but you know, in terms of brand presence, but it's also stunning in terms of design, and that is very unique. There are some pretty garish SUVs and crossovers that this thing competes against, and this is probably the only decent looking one of the bunch. Every one of my second row passengers said they're comfortable as well. Great thing about being behind the wheel is the steering wheel is fantastic in your hand. It's not an overblown thick rimmed steering wheel. Yeah, it does have a little bit of a flat bottom, and I know that's a lame trend that's played out and whatever, but the wheel is designed for your hands, feels great, the materials are fantastic as well. And the shift paddles, when you do use them, they're great. They're massive. They look like they come straight out of Ferrari, and perhaps that's the inspiration here.
Under the hood of the Stelvio is a 2-liter 4-cylinder with a twin-scroll turbo that makes 280 horsepower and 306 pounds of torque. And peak torque runs from 2,000 to 4,800 RPM, which gives it a ton of real-world flexibility. Once you're on the move, it's very responsive. Power goes through an 8-speed automatic and, of course, an all-wheel drive system. One of the key reasons the Stelvio is so much fun to drive is because they don't skimp on the brakes. Yes, there are Brembo calipers up front, and the brakes are all around excellent. For an SUV though, towing is limited to just 3,000 pounds, but that's well in line with the way Stelvio owners will use theirs.
While you've got plenty of power and plenty of torque, it's more than adequate in this thing. It's relatively quick. What is a bit of an annoyance is that when you start this thing up, it sounds a little hoarse. It doesn't sound like a very refined engine. It sounds like a ratty little four-cylinder. And you know, when you've started it up and you're sitting there and it's idling, it doesn't make the greatest sound. But after that, it's absolutely fantastic. The way it delivers power, the way it delivers torque is wonderful, and it's very, very modern given that it is turbocharged, of course. So it builds torque very much at the low end, and you can just ride this wave of torque, which is the modern way, of course, and makes for an easier drive. To get to my point here, if you are here for that question, should I buy one of these Alfa Romeo Stelvios? Well, my answer is an unequivocal yes. Buy this over everything else in the segment. It's got tons of charm. It's very interesting. It's got great presence. It looks stunning, and it's just fantastic in a lot of ways. And of course, in some of those other ways, like the infotainment unit, you're just gonna have to live with it. But this thing is so much more interesting than everything else in the segment. I highly, highly recommend it. It's something really special. And for 2018, if there's an SUV of the Year award, this might be it. This modestly priced Italian SUV is something really, really unique and really special, and would look great in your driveway. It's something very cool. And if I needed something like this, I would not hesitate to buy one. It has been a blast to test. I really, really don't want to give it back. It's just been a real thrill and just easy to live with, and you know, charming and lovely, and it turns heads. It's just been wonderful, and it's very, very Italian in terms of its overall presence, and I love that. Thanks for hanging out with us today and getting to the conclusion of should I buy an Alfa Romeo Stelvio. Hope you liked this piece, and if you did, be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. And that's the only way this channel is going to stay on the YouTube, so be sure to like it, share with your friends, and as always, we want to know what you think, so please leave a comment below. In the meantime, you can always check out our Julia video from a few months ago, and sometime in the near future, we'll be driving the 500 horsepower version of this Stelvio, so watch out for that. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.